540 horsepower, 510 pound-feet of torque.
If you want to impress other dudes in a parking lot, you'll need to remember those numbers. But remember, they're just numbers. The important thing is what you can do with them. It'll accelerate from 0 to 60 in 4.3 seconds, and it'll hit 100 in 9.4. So yeah, it's quick. What'd you expect?
Once you've gotten over the sheer novelty of lighting up the tires at will, you might be interested to know what it's like to actually drive the Shelby GT500.
Steers quick, but it's not overly darty, and there's lots of grip from the Goodyear F1 supercar tires. If you are lighting up the tire, just be careful where you decide to let them blow up, because if you happen to be in Palmdale on the weekend and you need a 19 series run flat tire, it's going to be hard to find. Ask me how I know. With this much power, the clutch is actually not too heavy, so I think my mom might be able to drive the GT500. And then the shifter has these nice short throws, which I really like, but the engagement is there's a little bit too much resistance. In terms of ride, it's obviously firmer than a lesser Mustang, say a GT, but it's not terrible. And also, the engineers have done a good job of getting out a lot of that truck-like bounciness that you expect from a car that has a live rear axle. And speaking of the live rear axle, that's the number one complaint you're going to hear from real performance enthusiasts. The Mustang GT500, that Shelby, it has a live rear axle instead of an independent rear suspension. It can't be a real performance car. And I guess to a certain extent they're right. Would it ride better? Would it be faster? Would it be a better overall car if it had an independent rear suspension? Well, yeah. But if you're like me, you're not setting lap records at the Nürburgring. You just want to drive like an idiot. And for that, it works great. Overall, it's better handling, it's faster, it's more refined than the Shelby GT500 from 2009. It even gets two better miles per gallon on the freeway. As though you give a... For more automotive news, please visit the latest news section of KBB.com.